Let's play! Whoa!
All right, they got this music freaking popping. All right. Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. You all may call me Pharaoh. And welcome to a brand new Let's Play. I think I made an update video years ago. I think years ago. About how I wasn't sure if I was going to cover this game because it's probably going to be copyrighted like crazy. But frankly, I don't care. You know, I want to know more of the story, and apparently this game has it. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my Let's Play of Kingdom Hearts, Melody of Memory. If you guys are not aware of this, this came out... Shoot, I want to say 2 years ago, but I could be completely wrong about that. But basically it's a Kingdom Hearts rhythm game. And if you guys don't know... I'm kind of a sucker for rhythm games. Like, I LP'd that Rhythm Thief game. That was pretty fun. And I absolutely adore the Hatsune Miku games. Like, those are like something I just kind of like relax to just play for the hell of it. And when I found out that this was coming out, I'm like, okay. I wasn't in a rush to get it. I waited until this game went down to $20 and then I picked it up. And then I haven't touched it until literally this recording now. So, it apparently has a little bit more story with apparently trying to find Sora after the ending of Kingdom Hearts 3. And frankly, this I kind of forgot a good chunk of the story, so we'll see how this goes. That's really all I can say about this. Let's just see what this game has in store for us and take it from there. If it gets, you know, copyrighted, so be it. Yeah. Oh, it's definitely getting copyrighted with this music. I don't think... I'm trying to push the buttons, but it's not doing anything. So I think it's just a... Is it? Hold on. It looks like there should be prompts, right? Like I should be pushing something? Oh my god, I was supposed to push X. I was pushing like circle and everything else, but... Oh yeah, oh my god, yeah. I'm literally playing right now. Well, damn. I didn't know I was supposed to... Oh wait, I don't know what the hell that one meant. They just threw me in here acting as if I shouldn't know what I have to do. I think I just hold down on that one. This one I hold. I don't know about this up one. I guess I push up as I push the button. And I'm wondering how I'm going to do this, because typically what I do for these LPs, I listen to the audio on my computer, because it's pretty instantaneous, although I'm not sure if it's 100%. So right now I'm just listening to the audio through the computer, and it seems like my prompts are still good. Now I do know there's a difference between like excellent and like the rainbow excellent. Absolutely no idea what the hell, like what's needed. I'm frankly, I've also been kind of like in a trophy hunting phase. I would like to platinum this game if I can, but we'll see. Welcome! Every adventure ahead of you, from battles to encounters with friends, unfolds through melodies and memories. AKA, that's why the game is called Melody of Memory. Some of these adventures take place in field battle music stages. In these stages, you battle enemies as you run on a musical staff to reach the end and clear the song. You can use different buttons to attack, jump, use abilities, and more. time your actions to match the timing guides that show exactly when to press a button. The outer circle will gradually shrink. Aim for the moment it lines up perfectly with the inner circle. Let's start a practice round. Okay. And, like, this game reminds me a lot of the Theatrum games on 3DS for Final Fantasy, or I think it's Theatrum, something like that. I adored those games, and this is what kind of reminds me of somewhat. Attack Enemies of X. Okay. It's a little weird there's no music playing right now. I can also use L1 and R1 if I so desire. Your team members attack using the same buttons. Okay. If you push any of the two of X, L1, R1 at the same time to attack two enemies at once. Okay. I'm already thinking, like, what I should probably do is, like, maybe use X for Sora, L1 for Donald, R1 for Goofy. Yeah, I feel like that might mesh well with my brain. We'll see. Push all three together at the same time to attack three enemies at once. Activate ability crystals with triangle to use a special skill or magic. There. Like thunder. Okay. And dodge range attacks by jumping with circle. Okay. If you encounter a flying enemy, press circle to jump, and then attack while you're in the air. Okay. Press and hold circle to glide and hit floating guide targets. Tilt the left stick left or right while gliding to move in that direction. Oh, crap. Up. Well, I kind of skipped what it said, but so be it. Release circle to land back on the ground. Good. Now try playing along the music. Alright, I think I got this. Let's try our best here. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to talk during the music or not. Through the variety, like, through the entirety of the game or not. It depends on how I feel, huh? Trying to get the timing down for the jumps. I guess in my head, there's like a depth perception thing. But I feel like it should be a lot further away than what it actually is. But I think I'll be okay. Now, I'm assuming this game also has like different difficulty levels. Frankly, when it comes to these like rhythm games, I end up using pretty much the highest difficulty, because it's actually, in my opinion, always been the most fun to do that. But I guess it also depends on just how bad it's gonna be. Like for Hatsune Miku, hell no. Like, those games, there's no way in hell I can ever play, like, on extreme or 2x extreme. Like, I think you need 6 hands to do that. I don't know how the hell those people do that. I got a full chain, too. Nice. Replay the tutorial? No. I think I got it. Your HP decreases every time you miss. If you reach the end with some HP remaining, you clear a song. Seems kind of lenient. Some enemies require multiple attacks to be defeated. The number above their timing guide tells you how many times to hit them. Yeah, we did see it with those large bodies. For more tips and tricks, go to tutorials and help in the config menu. Thank you. I might take a look into that. Is there not a story to this? They just shoved me right into this, huh? Here's the world map. My god, I'm getting like so many flashbacks to the first Kingdom Hearts. Pick a world and a song to get started. When controlling the gummy ship, press circle to return to the main menu. So what's up with these? It's a locked gate. Progress to the world tour. So that's how I get to different world and all that. Now, on the bottom left, dear God, what is all that? 345 gold stars. Are those Papu fruits? I don't know. 24 green, 75 blue, yellow, silver. No, there's 111, excuse me. So yeah, I'm not sure what any of that is. I can dash. And it tells me, so when we're on the world, it tells us, like, obviously what it is. So Destiny Islands, how many songs there are. I guess there's two in here. And if you do an all clear reward, which I guess that means like completing every single song, which makes me wonder that I don't think you need to finish every song in the game. Frankly, whatever they give me, I'm going to do. At least in the, I guess World Tour is the main menu. I don't know. Kairi 1? Memory Dive? MS Materia? I need 4 green missions to complete to open up this. And wow. Holy crap. It just me. It seems like quite a bit going on here, huh? Wow. And these are not like worlds we haven't been to before. These are all the worlds from all the games, I guess. Wow, yeah, that's Oh God, what the hell? I forgot the name of this town already. Like, I want to see the Land Before Time. That's I don't think that's correct at all. Wow, okay, this is a lot bigger than I thought. Holy fudge. Okay. Well then, let me go back. Okay, so here's the main menu. So, World Tour is you visit familiar worlds, unlock songs and movies, which I guess is like the story mode. It's the main mode of the game, and that's where I'm going to be focusing on. Things like track selection, I assume it's like just play whatever the hell you want, whenever. I doubt I'm going to do that on screen. Versus battles, obtain 10 field battle songs to unlock. I don't think I care for that. A museum, clear sun, and yeah, whatever. Oh, I didn't know this game has co-op in it. Interesting. Let me take a look at the config, actually. So, music stage settings. Volume. Directional button setting. Off. Standard. Oh, I can use the directional pads. Oh, so instead of using, like, the, like, circle X. Okay. I'll leave that off. Directional buttons for boss fights as well. If these are left off, I guess I'm just going to hold it off. Okay. Guest characters? Hell yeah, leave that on. Whew, this, I think, just depends on who you are. Many rhythm games will have something like this where you can adjust the timing. So, like, say you're going a little bit too fast, you can correct for that. If you're going too slow, you can correct for that. So I'm going to just leave everything as default, but okay. The menu volume, I don't know why. Okay, that's fine. Tutorials and help. Okay, well, we'll take a look at some of this. Use a summoning star to add King Mickey to your team for the duration of the song. He can attack enemies with rainbow timing guides and fully restore your HP from zero. Oh, wait. He can fully restore your HP from zero one time. These targets have rainbow-colored timing guides. King Mickey can hit them for a rhythm point bonus. If you see a guest icon when choosing a song, the pictured guest character will replace one of your team members for the duration of the song. Hit the friend orbs that appear for a rhythm point bonus. Your characters grow stronger as their stats improve. The higher the HP, the better chances of making it to the end of the song. Higher defense, the less damage you take. Makes sense. So what about strength, though? Does that really matter in a game like this? Timing guide colors. Different types of targets have different colored timing guides. Yellow's for enemies on the ground, blue's for enemies in the air, red is for enemies that you have to attack multiple times, and green is for ability crystals. If your strength is high enough, you can stun enemies that must be attacked multiple times. You will not take damage from stunned enemies even if you miss. So that's the whole point of strength. Okay. Dodge ranged enemy attacks by jumping in time with the red arrows. Clearing an arrow will always result in an excellent rating. Gotcha. You can also break boxes and barrels by attacking them. You will not take damage even if you fail to break them. Good to know. And if you're lucky, you may find a treasure chest containing an item at the end of a song. I guess this is completely randomized. So, there's going to be many more tutorials and tips, but I guess we'll get that later. Oh, we gotta actually get a clear world tour entirety to unlock this. Copyright! Yay! Okay. So, I guess that's that. If I push circle one more time, I go back here. Is there anything else? No, it just literally just goes right back in. Okay. Then I guess that's that. Let's go ahead and just begin with Destiny Islands. And here are two songs, Destiny Islands and Busted Up on the Beach. That's literally the names of these? Okay. Now you see here, oh, I guess they actually have missions as well. Clear without items, score, what is that, 5.2 million points or higher? Get 7% or higher, good or better ratings. Damn. And this is how you get the stars. Okay. Well, I think I'm going to try getting all the stars for all the missions if I can. Now, it's on beginner. Here's standard. And there's proud. Now, I'm assuming a number between each one or next to it is like how difficult it is. Is 10, like, really? Is it really that bad? I'm proud. We also have, like, the chain, our ranking for this, how many times we've played it. I guess if you just hit this play button on the right, you get to, like, listen to the music, and that's it. You don't actually have to play it. Now, it's interesting we can select... It looks like we select them, but we can't. I wonder if we can change them up. I don't know. And I guess we have items down here. Potions restore 30% of your HP. When your HP is at 40% or below, this restores 60% when your HP is at 20% or below. Increases item drop rate, doubles the amount of experience earned, and you can summon Mickey to a field battle. Gotcha. Well, oh crap, what the hell did I select? Was it standard? I might just choose standard for the time being. I don't know when I'll switch over to proud, but we'll see. Because I have a feeling that, Ease beginner might be like too like easy, and frankly, well, actually I say too easy, but funny enough, I feel like in these rhythm games, when you are, at least for me, when it's like really slow, it's actually harder than the songs that go really fast. I'm also trying to pay attention here, too. Oh! Did I miss it? You want to know why? I use a directional pad. I was hoping to get, like, a full chain on that one. That sucked. Well, it is what it is. So, yeah, like, depending on the song, I may not be talking too much. Frankly, it's kind of hard to talk and play this right now. Thunder. it's all good. Oh! Because sometimes these enemies, they can be the same type of enemy. Oh, crap. Oh, man, I completely missed. Oh, what's going on in my life? Well, that was terrible. Like, the same enemy's gonna have, like, the same, or, like, different, they can be on the ground, or you attack them in the air. Well, I passed, that, like, that, I mean, I knew I'm always gonna pass these levels, but, like, what's wrong with me there? I just completely just, I missed. That's not smart of me. So, yeah, whatever. So yeah, there's a difference between excellent and then rainbow excellent. What else we got going on here? We got like 94 music crowns? Got a clear bonus, high score bonus, star target bonus. Okay. So there's that. Tells us our rank. We cleared it. How much experience we get. Damn, level 4 already. Also got some items. I guess there's going to be synthesis. Okay. A new field battle song is not available to play in track selection. And I got my stuff. Track selection unlocked. Choose track selection from the main menu to play any song you like. I can now press options to open the team menu. Okay. I'm not... Here's the thing. I'm not gonna, like, always do my best on a world tour. I mean, as long as I pass it, I think that's really all I care about. I'm not gonna go gung-ho on perfecting songs, full chaining them. If it happens, it happens. If I don't do them, completely fine. Each song has 3 missions, so it's always 3. Complete these missions to collect stars, papu fruits, whatever, which you need to open gates. To open blue gates, collect the matching colored stars. Gates that require gold can be unlocked with gold of any color. Well, hold on, wait. Gates that require gold stars can be unlocked with stars of any color. Okay. To open red gates, you need to clear certain worlds or unlock certain gates. Interesting. Now, I pushed the options button because I'm curious about this team menu here. So I click team. Now, interestingly enough, yes, the set one is Team Classic. So we're going to get other teams, apparently. Well, that's interesting. Maybe I'll try them out when we actually unlock them. Sometime in the World Tour, we'll get them. I guess apparently also tells us we have various abilities. Thundaga and Ars Arcanum. Okay. Here we go. Here's synthesizing some enemies. Some items. You can synthesize new items and songs using materials you have obtained. It said items and songs? Wow. Okay. Interesting. The Moogle earns experience and gains levels as you synthesize items, just like in any other game. Well, I think it started with 2. As his level increases, you unlock new recipes and gain bonuses. After choosing an item to synthesize, select the material and press triangle to see how to obtain that material. Well, that's nice. Right off the bat tells you where you can find it. Okay. You can then jump directly to music stages from there. That's freaking quality of life. Nice. So it basically tells us, hey, if you want a potion, we need 6 blazing shards. Or we need these. Okay. Okay. So those are, like, those items. Like, these are the ones we saw, like, in the bottom of, like, the track selection. So there's that. Now here's music stage keys. So, unlocks a Sora Memory Dive MS and all these. Okay. Quite a bit here. I guess I'll be grinding a little bit. If you push square, tells us the Moogle level, and I guess for each level what it does. Like for example, level 2, Soothing Crystal Recipe and add-on material unlocked. Intermediate material, Hungry, Advanced Material Recipes unlocked. Okay. Interesting. So, eventually when I get enough, you know, materials, I will be synthesizing. I'm not sure if I'm going to do it on screen, but, you know, still. Profa card icons? Okay. Collector's cards. Still like characters, enemies. Wow. And then, I've always forgot about that. You can, if you have materials, you can actually make your own shards. Okay. I can make a lightning shard. Yeah, for Alville. Look, I did one. I had one neat CPD little experience, but there you go. Alright, and then items, I guess whatever we have. We do have an item boost already. And I guess we have these, yeah. Profa card icon featuring Sora, Donald, Goofy, Roxas, Shion, Axel, Riku, Meow Wow. My god, okay. Every time I look at Meow Wow, I just remember when I was fighting Azora in the DLC for Kingdom Hearts 3, and holy crap, I just kept accidentally using the Meow Wow summon. Komori Bat, Aqua, Ventus, Terra, King Mickey, Aladdin, Ariel, Peter Pan, Beast, Hercules, Mulan, Simba, Experiment 626. That's right, I don't think they ever called them Stitch in these games, do they? An illustration of Sora. Well, that is some. That's a classic right there. Holy crap. Okay. And we already saw the music stage settings, so there you go. Well, that was fun. All right. Let's do this. Busting up on the beach. We need a 6% or higher, 55 or more ground enemies. Okay, we got this in the bag. You can change difficulty and set items to use before starting a song. Use L1 R1 to select difficulty. Beginner is the easiest, proud is the hardest. Press X to set potions and other items to be used automatically as you play. Okay. Well, you know, we tried standard. I mean, this is probably going to be stupid. Let's try proud. With me talking and me trying to, you know, concentrate, this will probably not go well. But let's see. You see how it's a little faster? Oh yeah, it's definitely faster. Me talking is it's probably not gonna. Oh god. Somehow I have my chain still going. Now I'm sure I'm gonna jinx it. Guy has a lot of attacks he has left on his body. Damn. Did I lose my chain without realizing? I didn't know what the hell I was doing with my life there. I'm telling you, this brings back so many memories, guys. Like, I love music in video games. Like, they absolutely do so much for me. And that's why I feel like this game was, like, perfect for me. Jesus. Oh my god, I died? I can't believe I died. I was close, too. I was kind of close. Wow. Yeah, so I definitely cannot play and talk at the same time. I'm still doing things. Yeah, though, let's play. No, actually, let's return to World Tour. I didn't clear it, did I? No, I didn't clear it. Okay. So yeah, like I can probably talk and play as I'm doing in standard, but. If I'm gonna try getting a good score, there's no way in hell I can talk and play. And you know, maybe I'll go back. Maybe I just will shut up during these music sections and that's it. Then again, I don't think it'll be much of an LP, you know. But you know, I guess it depends what you guys would like. You know, I'm fine either way. I mean, I don't need to like talk. During these sections. Or maybe, like, I'll just interject here and there, you know? Something that frankly, I'm still trying to learn out of all these years of LP is, like, I don't need to constantly speak, you know? I can just enjoy the game and I don't need to fill every single thing with commentary. But everybody has their own style, right? Like, oddly enough, I think it's coming up to 13 years I've been doing this on and off, you know? And I'm like, crap, where the hell the time gone, you know? That's life, right? They seem pretty lenient with the timing so far. Unless I'm mistaken, I don't know. Now, I haven't taken a look at, like, what the trophies are for this game. I'm curious, like, maybe I'll check it out after this song. See, are people getting the platinums for it? Are they not? But there you go. Not bad at all. Wasn't a full chain, but I'll take it. Probably gonna be getting a lot of A pluses, it seems like. Sure. Look at all these numbers and got Frost Shard, Lucid Shard. Now, what is it? It says number 142 Titus, and I got something else before too. I don't. What does that do? I don't know. So yeah, I got the song, the Spinanza track selection. I got all the missions done. Here we go. Story scene number 53, Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep. So wait, collector's card obtained for collect 200 rhythm points. That's what they are? These are just cards? So the Titus one, that's a card, huh? Okay. Now, you see a little play or reel symbol next to the Return of World Tour. I'm assuming when we see things like this that we're actually going to get story. So, let's see how this goes.
Led by a mysterious voice, Sora stepped through the door that marked the start of his journey. Sora, Riku, and I wanted to see the world beyond our island. One day, Sora came face to face with a man from another world. Meanwhile, Donald and Goofy received a letter from Mickey asking them to find the holder of a certain key.
Now hold on a minute, are we gonna be getting like literally a recap of the story? I thought we were gonna get more story. Maybe not. I don't know, maybe a little bit of both. Kyrie 1 Memory Dive MS Material. Material obtained for clearing all songs in this world. Now once again, I guess it does not matter. I guess we don't need to clear all the songs in the world as long as we... a trophy! Cleared all songs in the world. I think it's as long as we have enough to progress to other gates and other worlds, I guess that's enough, but... Frankly, I'm going to do all the songs that they present to me. Cleared all songs for the world for the first time! Nice. Now let's take a look at the... Really quick. The trophies. There's 45 of them. Well, oddly enough, getting a platinum doesn't seem that bad. I mean, I guess it's considered very rare. 7.8% of players earned. That's actually kind of high up. And frankly, all these are all hidden trophies. So, maybe this won't be too bad. I think it's just Alive is going to be just grinding. But, I mean, frankly, I'm okay with that. So, cool. Alright. So, there's that. Now, how do I unlock this again? We simply just need to progress through the world thing. So, we just can't do this at all yet. Okay. So I think when we have choices like this, I think I'm going to save whatever story-related one, if you want to say, for last. So let's go for here. This is, isn't this Destiny Islands as well? Yeah, it's a darkened world. Hold on really quick. That's what it says. Come here, it's the Destiny Islands. Darkened world. So I guess... They're just dark versions of places we've been to before. Only one song, Night of Fate. Destroy 35 total shadow enemies. Okay. Let's go for it. I'm telling you guys, the music really brings me back. Like, I remember being so excited for the series. And when it first came out, I was 10, 11. Here I am, 31. And I'm still a fan. Do I wish, Could a series be better? Could the games be better sometimes? Of course, you know. But frankly, I still enjoy what the series has to offer. I don't think anybody can change my mind on that one. Unless they, like, do something really stupidly drastic that I'm like, what are you doing with your life? Now, see, sometimes the timing for these, it just goes really fast. Like, I guess I'm sometimes used to having, like, the rhythm, like, the shrinking of the circles, like, all sometimes have, like, the same beat to it, if that makes sense. It seems like it's a little bit different here. I don't know. And thankfully, the music seems to kind of go along nicely with, like, the track itself. Like, a lot of times, like, that's how I play these games, you know? I rely on my memory of the song itself to know when to push the buttons. Kind of close to messing some of these up. I mean, so far, so good. All right. And, like, they have, like, a progress thing in the bottom left, but frankly, I'm not even paying attention to that. So that was a full chain. Nice. Okay, so that might be at least an S ranking there. I'd imagine so. So I'm fairly certain I also got... Wow, not even S ranking. It's an A++. Maybe this game doesn't have S's in it. I don't know. But, okay, cool. So I got that song, and I got all the things. Cool. Got 6 blazing shards for the helmet, because I have 300 things. Another trophy! Thank you! Got a full chain! Achieved my first full chain. Well, thank you, game. Awesome. And, that was it. Yeah, complete. I got the Summoning Star for clearing all songs in this world. And see, like, now, I don't even need, I guess, technically, I don't need to go here, but I feel like, you know, what's the point? You know, like, I want to see what everything, what it has to offer there. This is complete too, right? Okay. This is Traverse Town, right? Why is it... look a little different. Anyway, so this is another darkened world of Destiny's Island. This is Destiny's Force. Missed 30 or fewer times. Clear of 30%. Yeah, I think we got this one. You know what? For the hell of it, let's try a Summoning Star. So it is set, right? Yeah. Okay. It just kind of gets highlighted. So. My god, I remember the first time fighting Darkseed, whatever the hell this thing's name is, like, I was like, that's cool, and then you find out you have to, like, fight the damn thing, like, over and over and over again. There's Mickey, alright. I'm curious to know how, like, boss fights are going to be like in this game. I'm assuming pretty much the same, right? I could be wrong. I almost messed that up. I don't know why I didn't think that, like, hey, the game could mix a ability crystal with one of the attacks as well. Okay, or like, or these items too, or like the barrels, I should say. Okay. We're halfway there, we got this. Of course, I would like to always get full chains when I can or whatever, but something tells me, of course, you probably can get better scores like that. I'm assuming there's a bunch of trophies attributed to, like, you know, being amazing at this game. At the same time, I mean, having a platinum rating of 7.8% of people getting it, I still think that's pretty damn high. I guess we'll see, right? I was kind of worried about that. I was actually worried about that. There we go. I was trying to push triangles sometimes there. I'm glad frankly, I think I did miss it because my chain is not high again. I think I actually pushed triangle when I was supposed to push X. Damn. Yeah, it is what it is. A++ regardless. Alright, now we got a selfie card, I guess. Alright. Oh crap, this is we shouldn't use items. I'll do that one off screen or something. Got another summoning star, frost shard, another story scene. Alright, let's watch another cutscene.
One fateful night, darkness consumed Destiny Islands. As Riku disappeared into the darkness, my heart managed to escape to safety inside Sora. The darkness overwhelmed Sora, and he awoke in an unfamiliar town.
Good old Traverse Town. I always enjoyed it for what it was. I got this collector's card for clearing all the songs in the world. That gate opened up. I guess I can go straight to that instead of going to Traverse Town if I so desire, but you know that's not going to be the case. Now notice here, it says cleared. Doesn't say complete, like the other. I'm curious. You know what? I'm actually gonna do it right now. So guys, give me a moment. I'll be right back. There you go. There's the other star I was missing. And so as long as like the rhythm points are the things up there in the top right. The more we get of those, the more bonuses I guess we get. Or items, whatever the hell you want to call it. So what I'm curious, yeah, there you go. So that's what I wanted to check out. I'm like, so does it go to clear to complete after I get all the missions done? And sure enough, that's exactly what it is. Okay. So we got Traverse Town, and we also got the Darkened World, so interesting. So I think what I'm going to do is that I'll finish off these two worlds, and I'll probably call the video. So starting with Traverse Town, we have, oh man, dear God, a classic. Just do the Traverse Town theme. Get 65% or higher, hit all star targets with a rating of excellent or better. See, that one, I don't know if I'm going to be able to do, because I feel like my timing can be a little off. Let's just hit all star targets. I wonder what they mean by that. Clear on, I guess, beginner or... Oh, wait a minute. No, I'm sorry, that's two. I was like, is that one? I don't know why the hell I thought that was No, it's two, okay. So, clear on standard or proud without any items. That's fine. I'm not sure I can get all those star targets, but here we go. Freaking Traverse Town, though. I really enjoyed this world in the original Kingdom Hearts. It was one of my favorite, like, chill, places or, like, chill worlds until freaking we were introduced to, Twilight Town. I say all the time that, like, oh man, I would live in Twilight Town if it existed. And maybe it does. I just don't realize. See, damn it. That's what I keep pushing triangle anytime to attack when there's like three enemies. It's gonna get used. It's gonna take some getting used to hit L1, R1, or X to attack. I'm surprised that one missed. Pretty sure I pushed the button, but I guess not. Now, I don't know what star targets are talking about. I'm sure I missed it already. But I mean, that just means I got some grinding to do off screen. I know I said I wasn't going to try, like, perfecting this game, but I feel like the very least I can try doing the freaking the missions. So, okay. So there we go. Pretty sure I missed that whatever star rating I had to do there, but everything else I think I got. Freaking love Traverse Town. Didn't do so hot there in the middle, but so be it. And what else did I get? Apparently I was close. So I got 88%. Hit all star targets with a rating of excellent or better. I did not see what they designated as a star target. Okay, I'll do that. Like I said, I'll do that one off screen. Experience boost as well. Okay. And the next song is Hand in Hand. Score a lot of points, miss 19 times or fewer, clear 50%. Oh, we got this. Yeah, for the hell of it, because we have items. Let's use an experience boost. Made sure, like, that freaking mission didn't say, like, oh, to make sure I don't use an item. No, I can use an item now. There we go. Hey, is it a waste? Yeah, probably, but who cares? So yeah, this is the battle theme within anytime you're in Traverse Town. I remember not liking fighting the enemies like the second time around we were in Traverse Town, because like that's when like, oh my god, you had like harder enemies and whatnot, but frankly, it was all good. So I think I actually saw what they meant by star target. Like, they actually have a little star around them, like, for the timing guide. I think that's what it was. I could be wrong, though. Guess you, I could have sworn they had it. I don't know. And I like how, like, the gliding music notes really fall in line with the music track. I don't know, you know, like, playing this makes me feel like I should play the original games again. Because God knows the LPs I have out there are just terrible, because, like, you know, low quality, whatever. Oh, crap. Same time, and it's like, you know, there's so many other things I want to do. Like, I just don't want to, like, take more time playing a game that I've already done, you know? You know, I never know, like, how things change, so I'm surprised I even got hit there. I thought I hit it. Oh, well. But I'm pretty sure I got all the, all the missions there. Now, why the hell am I getting work emails now? Come on now. Okay. Got the song. And got all the missions done. Also got a soothing crystal because I have 900 rhythm points. And oh wow, another trophy. Experience Hunter. earn 2,000 experience for more in a song, and frankly, that was thanks to the experience boost, right? So, okay. So that takes care of that world. Like I said, I'll take care of the other mission off screen. Now, is this going to be a boss or not? I don't know. I mean, this was a boss song. But I don't know if it's going to be a boss level. Shrouding Dark Cloud. So don't use any items. Get 70 or more good or better ratings, which I think will be fine. And defeat all multi-attack items. Or multi-attack enemies. Who knows if I'm going to get that one or not. So, now here's the thing. You always got to make sure you unselect the item. Like, it keeps it selected no matter what. So, if you guys don't want to use an item, make sure you take that off. I love the little chibi versions. That's how it was in Theatrum Final Fantasy or whatever the hell it's called. Now wait a minute, was this the boss theme or not? I can't remember now. For the guard armor. I'm pretty sure it was. Oh my god, my memory has been absolute crap. I feel like those guys just kind of run at you a little bit. That's what it seems like. Now, when they mean multi-attack enemies, I think they're talking about, like, the ones where you have to hit them multiple times. I think that's what they mean by multiple attack, right? Man, it's right there in the name, but I don't know. I overanalyze crap like crazy, you guys know me. Because at first when I thought multi-attack, I thought they meant, like, groupings of enemies. Where you'd use, like, you know, one, two or three to attack. Oh, crap, well... I think so far, I've only done, like, what, one full chain? It's not a big deal, but... Now, see, I think I just missed it. I did not hit all, you know, everything, so I missed that freaking clear target. I know I did. Damn it all. What is wrong with me? That happens a lot when it comes to games like this, where it's like, I'm right there at the cusp of winning and getting it, and then I just mess up. Oh, well. Yeah. 71%. Okay. Well, I totally got the other two. That's fine. I obtained Simple and Clean. I got a new memory dive song available to play in track selection. Well, good for me. I also got Simple and Clean to play. Okay. Let's watch the video.
Having been chosen by the Keyblade, Sora teamed up with Donald and Goofy. The trio traveled together through many worlds, locking the world's keyholes in order to keep them safe from the encroaching darkness. Meanwhile, Riku awoke in the dark depths.
So I like the idea. It looks like they're going to go back and forth between Sora and Riku's story. It's important, obviously. Okay. And now with that, we have opened up freaking Wonderland and Agrabah. It looks like Halloween Town as well. And freaking, my God. Oh my God, what was that world called? The Little Mermaid's world. Oh my God, it's not Atlantis. Oh my God. Atlantica, I think. So in some worlds, guest characters may join your team. Friend orbs appear when you have a guest in your team and hit those targets for a rhythm point bonus. Guest characters leave after the end of the song, but they will reappear if you keep playing the same song. Cool. So it is Atlantis, right? No, not Atlantis, Atlantica. Okay, that was right. Okay, Atlantica. So it seems like there's like two songs each. Okay. I think we can start that in the next episode. What I would like to do is probably off screen. I'm going to go ahead and take care of these missions because it's just bothering me that I didn't get them. So I think I'll go ahead and do that. And then starting with the next video, we'll clear out these four classic levels and continue forward. Man, I like this. I really do. It's, I don't know how to describe it. Like, to me, it's a huge nostalgia thing. As I mentioned before, I completely love the music and video games. Kingdom Hearts is absolutely, is no exception. I remember I wanted to go to, they had like a Kingdom Hearts, like orchestra and thing going on, but I think that was right in the cusp of when COVID was like really new and really bad. And I mean, shoot, even now it's still terrible, but you guys know what I mean. But yeah, that's the plan for the next video. So as usual, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all next time for Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Melody of Memory. Love you all so much, and do not forget to spread that love around. Have a great day.